the man behind the show. Respected the Ramoji Rao garu. See Sam Nagarji. And just now we heard King of Delta State Nigeria, His Excellency Orphan Richard Agoni. All the other dignitaries of the dais, the distinguished gathering of the evening, brothers and sisters. I'm extremely happy to be addressed to you today in this historic city, Ramoji Film City, for this historic occasion. I feel very happy that this Indywood Carnival, a new initiative to bring the world cinema to India, the initiative has been taken, getting good response, and being held in a prestigious film city, Ramoji Film City. Sri Ramoji Rao garu is a legend. I call him the modern Brahma, because Brahma is a creator. Brahma is a creator. You go around the studio, you see the film city, you will understand his creative capacities. He's a creator, he's an architect, he's an engineer, he's everything for that matter. Because everything here, which is created in this famous film city, was all planned, designed, thought by him. That's why I really feel proud that such a man, who is instrumental in getting this Ramoji Film City, is one of the great wonders of the world. That's why we all have given him that small lifetime achievement award. He is not only a Brahma for this Ramoji Film City, he created a newspaper revolution in the country, in order. He brought a revolution in the television, ET. He brought a revolution even in agriculture magazine, Annadata, Chatura, Vipula. So many other things, even Pickens also, he created history. You all know, I will not explain. Because he's a creator, he's a thinker, he's a doer. And he has the character, caliber, capacity to conduct, discipline, dynamism, dedication, and devotion, all in one. That's why he's an icon, not only to Telugu people, to many of the people in the country. Such creativity, such hard work, and such discipline, and such commitment is very rare. So he's a role model to many of us in various public fields. And friends, today, the cinema. Cinema is the biggest entertainment in the world for the humanity. There's no competition to cinema. Because cinema entertains people. Cinema engages people. Cinema guides people. Misguides people also sometimes. Cinema gives a message. Cinema motivates the people. Cinema makes the people to enjoy at least part of their day's time. And cinema gives us all ideas about past. Cinema also gives us a vision of the future. And cinema that way is part of the life. So that's why cinema has an important role in the life of the people of the world. That's why today, I have access about two things. One is cinema is very great entertainer. Second, he is bringing this Indywood, new concept. Hollywood, Bollywood, now Indywood. Because India culture, heritage, music, literature, art is very ancient. ఆది కాలం నుంచి వేదకాలం నుంచి పుణ్యకాలం నుంచి పురాణకాలం నుంచి మన పూర్వీకులు అనుభవించి రంగరించి వెళ్ళవచ్చిన వారసత్వం ఏంటో భారతదేశానికి ఒకప్పుడు భారతదేశాన్ని ప్రపంచానికి విశ్వగురు అని చెప్పి పిలిచేవాడు. ప్రపంచం నుంచి వచ్చా వచ్చి విద్యార్థులు ఇక్కడ నలంద తక్షశర విశ్వవిద్యాలయంలో చదువుకుని వెళ్ళేవాడిని. యువన్ సాంగ్ వాహ్యాన్ అంటే చైనీస్ ఆ రోజు టూరిస్టులు కేమ్ అంటే రోడ్ అబౌట్ ఇండియా. వీ హావ్ గ్రేట్ పాస్ట్, వీ హావ్ గ్రేట్ హిస్టరీ, వీ హావ్ గ్రేట్ కల్చర్, we have great civilization. So we should cherish it. So that's why, as suggested by Sohan Roy, if Indian films they take little more interest, we can guide the entire world film industry also. We have the capacity and caliber. Friends, the second reason for me to accept is for my liking and my admiration for this great man, Sri Ramoji Rao. Because as I told you, he is a creator and he is number one in many of the things. And he gives us a great inspiration. Why even felicitate people? Why give these awards? Awards and rewards, praise Babu. Awards and rewards are too small for him. But this is not an award for him. This is an award for the recognition of the great work done by him. And this award or this felicitation is for inspiration. Felicitation is for inspiration. Inspiration to all of us. Inspiration to the new generation. Inspiration to the younger generation. That's why this felicitation. That's why I already agreed, in spite of my busy schedule of going here and there, moving around, I thought I should also come out here and spend some beautiful time. Friends, today I can also share with you, it's one of the wonderful days for me. Normally I don't get to read up. And I don't go to much of the cinemas also. My knowledge about cinema is very limited. My knowledge about the cinema people is unlimited, I know much of them, including our great Hollywood actor, Mr. Rajendra Prasad was telling that he's an Hollywood actor also. I know many of these people from my old days. And cinema actors, they also made a great impact on the life and minds of the people. So we have a special liking for them. Friends, today, as I told you, it's a wonderful day, not only to meet you, but also I could spend 1.5 hour of my time going around Ramoji Film City along with Ramoji Rao garu. Normally I don't get that luxury of seeing film cities or going around and then seeing such a, and spending such wonderful time. Because I rarely get time. My amma cheptundi appudu ma nana mind ki kuda vastundadu ani cheppadu. And also we have a wonderful Prime Minister who do not sleep and do not allow others also to sleep. He makes everybody work. Not only that, there is a complaint against the Prime Minister now. Some people complain also, who kaate nahi kisi ko khane dete nahi. He doesn't eat and doesn't allow others also to eat. Not the food. Khana khane ke bare mein nahi, khana maggi nahi, baggy. Who kaate nahi kisi ko khane dete nahi. We are fortunate to have such a great leader who is leading the country. This International Film Festival, like this, creates an ideal platform for exchange of views by filmmakers and film lovers from different regions and different parts of the world. That's why I call it a wonderful occasion. Secondly, one does not need to be an expert in a particular language to understand the nuances of aesthetics and cinematic excellence. Cinema has no barrier. Art has no barrier. It cuts across the barriers also. The medium of cinema easily connects people from different countries. It does not need words to define itself, but a heart full of emotions. In Bharata's Natya Shastra, drama has been defined as the fifth Veda. It is said that all celestial beings went in a delegation to pole face Lord Brahma. They prayed for giving them something which could yet be once and heard and could entertain even the lowliest. That was the request made to Brahma. Lord Brahma went into profound contemplation and created drama. It was meant to give dharma. Drama is for dharma, to guide the people. Artha and Yash, divineness, material benefit and fame, all these three are also important, which would, an amalgamation of all scriptures and all arts, and instruct people in all their works. Cinema is the modern evolution of drama. Drama was past. Cinema is present. It captures the imagination of the classes and the masses also. It is the meeting point of all arts, scripting, screenplay, acting, music, playback, singing, costume, choreography, cinematography, editing, recording, dubbing, etc. All in one, that is cinema. It is a great opportunity. You come with the script, you finish the film, and go back with the cassette. That is what Ramoji Rao has created, and through Ramoji Film City here. Director is a Brahma, or he or she is creating a parallel universe. So take care what you create. I only appeal to the creators, please take care of what you create. Should it enrich the viewers or degenerate them? One has to think about it seriously. Should it make them a profounder human being or a shallower Films are a visual education. They are a great education. That's why the producers, the directors, the scriptwriters, and screenplay people, all of them have to be extra careful. People tend to unknowingly make good films a permanent part of their lives. Films can provide sukha, sustenance, and become virtual memory. Cinema chodda vanna manushulaku kanisam taatkalikamaina swantanam labhistundi. Santosham labhistundi. Manasika ullasam labhistundi, vishranthi labhistundi. మనసులో ఉండే అశాంతిని కూడా సినిమా తొలగిస్తుంది. అంత శక్తివంతమైన ఆయుధం సినిమా. అందువల్ల దాన్ని చక్కగా ఉపయోగించుకోవాల్సింది, మంచిగా ఉపయోగించుకోవాల్సింది. సమాజానికి మార్గదర్శనం చేసేందుకు, సమాజానికి ఉత్సాహాన్ని, ఉత్తేజాన్ని, ఉల్లాసంతో పాటు వారికి సందేశాన్ని ఇచ్చే విధంగా సినిమా ఉంటే ఎంతో ఉపయోగకరంగా ఉంటుందని నేను భావిస్తుంది. ద సెకండ్ ఇండివుడ్ ఫిల్మ్ కార్నివల్ ఇస్ కమింగ్ టు ఎ క్లోజ్ టుడే. ఐ హోప్ ఇట్ హెస్ బీన్ ఎ ఫుల్ఫిలింగ్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఫర్ ఫిల్మ్ మేకర్స్, ఫిల్మ్ జర్నలిస్ట్, film critics, distributors, and film enthusiasts. Had the rain gods not been furious upon Hyderabad, it would have been more picture perfect. But I commend this idea of film carnival. And I also compliment the Telangana Chief Minister Sri K. Chandrasekhar Rao for extending all the support for this film festival in this historic city of Hyderabad, and particularly in Ramoji Film City. First, it shows growing private initiative in a film festival. Second, through film bazaar, it afforded business opportunity for good ideas. Third, it affirms that Indian films are more than Bollywood and Hollywood. The dynamics of filmmaking and film business is fast changing. Today, films are no longer restricted to a 3-hour format. One could shoot a film in a few minutes, long film, even on a cell phone, and release it on YouTube. That's the problem. The advent of multiplexes and shopping malls have dovetailed other retail business with films also. Previously, a film hall used to be a standalone institution. Now there is a serious investment in multiple chains. PVR, Big Cinema, Enox, Prasas, IMAX, to name a few. Hits and flops are decided comparatively shorter period. Gone are the days where late N.K. Rama Rao or A. Nageswar Rao or Sivaji Ganeshan, or N.G. Ramachandran, or Dilip Kumar, or Raj Kumar, they used to run for 365 days. Now if a film is run for 5 days, that's a great film today. You know, because it's being released in a number of theaters. Those days, heroes and heroines, they used to be remembered for years. And they used to act for years also. But nowadays, fast changing. We don't remember the name of the hero or heroine after the cinema is over. Because the new trends that are coming to the film, the actions, even if you have a lot of people, Srungaram, Kalato, Mukavalikarato, Kalpamarato, Srungaram, Valiki, Chavalu, Taki, Valiki, 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 ఎందుకు ఈ పరిస్థితి వచ్చిందనే విషయాన్ని అందరూ ఆలోచించవచ్చు. శృంగారం జీవితంలో బంగారం, అది కంగారం. దాని గురించి ఎవరు కంగారు పడాల్సిన అవసరం లేదు. కానీ శృంగారము ఆ సౌందర్యము అది ఒక సంస్కారంతో కూడినట్టు ఉండాలి. ఆ సంస్కారం అనే సినిమాలు తీసేవాడికి నమస్కారం మనందరం పెట్టాలని చెప్తున్నారు. సినిమాలు సందేశంతో తీస్తే ఆ సినిమాలు విజయవంతం కావాలి. Look at Mr. Ramoji Rao. How many films he has produced? All of them with a message, and many of them are big hits in spite of lacking the so-called Srungaramo, Lekapothe Itara Angaramo, Dharanayaka Vinyasamo, Alanti Takkuvainappudu Kuda, Oka Chakkani Sandeshanni, Oka Chakkani Uttrutanni, Oka Chakkani Natananu Varu Aa Cinemala Dwara Manaku Andicharu, Pedda Udaharanaga Manaku Andicharu, Sam Venkaiah Naidu Garu Naidu. ఇంకా అనేక మంది అలాంటి దర్శకులు ఉన్నారు. వాళ్ళందరూ కూడా మనందరినీ ఆలోచనలు లేకేసేపడేసేటక్క, ఉత్తేజపట్టే విటక్క, ఉత్సాహపట్టేటక్క సినిమాలు తీశారు. ఆ సినిమాలు మనం చూసే ముందుకైతే సంవత్సరాలు నడిచాయి. కానీ లోకం మారుతూ ఉంది. ఇదంతా ఇన్స్టెంట్ కాఫీ, ఇన్స్టెంట్ కాఫీ అంతా కూడా వన్ డే సినిమా. ఈ పరిస్థితి వస్తుంది. దీని గురించి ఆ సినిమా పరిశ్రమ గట్టిగా ఆలోచించవలసి ఉంది. ఎంతకాలం గుర్తుపెట్టుకునే సినిమాలు ఈ ఆ సంవత్సరం ఉంది. ఒక రామానంద సాగర్, ఆ రోజుల్లో కానీ మహాభారతమో రామాయణమో వస్తుందంటే ఎక్కడ వాళ్ళు అక్కడ ఆగిపోయేవాళ్ళు, అందరూ టీవీ ముందు ఆకట్టుకుని నిలబడేట పరిస్థితి ఉండేది. ఇవాళ ప్రచారం ఎక్కువైంది, ఆర్భాటం ఎక్కువైపోయింది, లోపలేమో సరుకు తక్కువైంది. దాంతోపాటు మనందరికీ కూడా తెలుసు, సంగీతము సాహిత్యము జనాన్ని కట్టిపడేసి ద లిటరేచర్ అండ్ మ్యూజిక్ ఇట్ హాస్ ఎ ట్రెమెండస్ ఇంపాక్ట్ ఆన్ ద పీపుల్. సంగీతము సాహిత్యము తక్కువైపోయాయి, ఇప్పుడు వాయిద్యం ఎక్కువైపోయింది, వాయించబడాలి. ఇది ఎంతవరకు మేలు జరుగుతుంది మనకు అనే విషయాన్ని కూడా సినిమా రంగం ఆలోచించబడి అవసరం ఉంది. ఈ డైరెక్టర్స్ ఆర్ యాంగింగ్ టు కమ్ టు ఫార్ములా ఫిలిమ్స్. మీనింగ్ఫుల్ స్క్రిప్ట్స్ ఆర్ ఫైండింగ్ మార్కెట్ అమౌంట్ ఆడియన్స్ ఫెడ్ విత్ ద ప్రెడిక్టబుల్ స్టోరీస్. సినిమా ఇస్ ఎ టెక్నో ఆర్ట్. టుడే ఇట్ హాస్ బికమ్ ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్లీ ప్రొఫెషనల్ అండ్ కాన్ఫరెన్స్ in its approach. What will be the impact of such corporation of creativity is another debate. Let the debate go on. But today, it is being perceived as an investment opportunity and employment generator more than ever. New film and entertainment-oriented ventures funds with an average size of 2 billion have come up in the recent years. Various films are offering solutions for filmmakers to make strategic decisions about their budgets, conduct cost-benefit analysis, and measure audience response on various industries. Film publicity is becoming highly professionalized. There is a special focus on film consumption habits in Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities. Film tourism is being seriously strategized. Film and entertainment were officially recorded the status of industry in 2001 during the Atal Bihari Vajpayee government. But much of it has not been put into practice. That is the complaint what our film industry friends are telling to me. After I took over as the Minister of I&B, I have decided that I will be shortly calling the representatives of the film industry and have an in-depth discussion with them. I will try to find out solutions to some of the challenges faced by the film industry, including piracy. Indian film industry is worth 126 billion in 2014 and expected to touch 204 billion in 2019 as per the picky KPMG report. We are in the midst of interesting times, some would call them filmic. Amongst the regional film industry, Tamil and Telugu have market leaders. They are churning out more movies than Bollywood. And analysts feel the trend will hold. In South, the bilingual film like Tamil, Telugu or Malayalam, Kannada, Tamil are becoming trendsetters. Film production has always been private enterprise in India. There were few avenues for government assistance before the establishment of a national film development corporation under the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. Government have many things to do. Government has no business to be in business. Government has no business to be in films. If the government produces a film, how it will be, you can understand. That's why I don't expect the government to produce any film. There is an anecdote that when Satyajit Rai was staking his everything to produce Bhattare Panchali, Legend of Road, in early 1950s, he went to Dr. Pradhan Chandra Rai, the then Chief Minister D.C. Rai of Bengal. Dr. Rai said he was helpless. But on hearing the title contained the word road, Ray raised some money from PWD. Thanks to the PWD fund, Satyajit Rai would finish his dream that became a legend. NMDC filled the vacuum to a certain extent. The government in reality has no business to be in film industry. But it has a duty to facilitate films. It has a duty not to create the problems for the films. Government did not do anything. What film industry is asking, please don't create problems. I can assure you, in future we will not create any problems. By simplifying the rules and compliances. On the other hand, it has a duty to facilitate good films and film workers. It has a duty to give space to good films as part of visual education to audience. Towards this direction, the newly independent India made two good initiatives. One was the starting of the International Film Festival of India in 1952 and the National Film Awards were instituted in 1954 to recognize the talent, to facilitate the achievers. Films are being made in all modern languages of India. But when I say film like Crossing Bridges 2013, the first ever film made in Chhattisgarh language, a dialect of Arunachal Pradesh, wins the National Award. It's indeed a matter of joy that a dialect has won the National Award. It's an event perhaps in the annals of the language as Raja Harishchandra was in the annals of Indian cinema. India is home to one of the largest film industries in the world. Every year, thousands of movies are produced in India by lakhs of artists, technicians, specialists in different disciplines, in different languages, portraying the vibrant culture of India. It is difficult to think of another nation which has a cinema as diverse in language, content and form that both entertain and educate as that of ours, a nation with vibrant film industry producing large number of films which are viewed worldwide. Government of India has been taking several steps towards promoting Indian film industry, promoting India as a film destination, showcasing India films towards preserving of film heritage and screening industry. One such initiative is the Film Film States Office, which has recently been set up to promote and facilitate film shootings by international filmmakers in India. The Film Film States Office would act as a facilitation point for the film producers in helping them in getting requisite permission. It would also disseminate the information on shooting locations and the facilitate available in the Indian film industry what are the facilities for production, post-production activities. The FFO would closely work with the state of registration of film shootings in the country. The FFO is being operated by National Film Development Corporation from its office in Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai and Kolkata. With a view to protect, preserve our filmic heritage, government is implementing a scheme, National Film Heritage Mission, at a total cost of 597 crores. National Film Archive of India is going to be created in Pune. Pune has been designated as an implementing agency for the mission. In order to implement this project in an effective manner, we held stakeholders consultation involving film producers, writers, historians, film lab covering different centers of film making, including Hyderabad. The Government of India and my ministry proposed to set up a National Center for Animation, National Center of Excellence for Animation, Gaming and Visual Effects. Setting up this animation center is part of the budget announcement. The objective of this center is to build a national center of excellence to impart world-class education at affordable fee structure in animation, gaming, visual effects and comics, and create a world-class talent pool in India to cater to the Indian global players. The project initiates operation of the center with the help of a private partner. We are moving in the direction. Film festivals in India are stepping stones towards transforming, integrating Indian film industry by bringing more and more techniques in film making as well as technology, which includes creation of state-of-art production facilities. Friends, the 47th edition of the Film Festival of India is going to be held in Goa, Honorable Ministry, scheduled on 20th to 28th November 2016. It's another occasion. In addition to the existing package of world cinema, the festival will also master classes on different aspects of filmmaking featuring some of the eminent international filmmakers. I take this opportunity to welcome you all to that film festival in Goa, because everybody should learn. I always tell not only students, everybody, including ministers, should learn, 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 not yearn, yearn, yearn. You should all learn, learn more. Once you land, then you can end. Without land, if you start end, then there is a possibility of going wrong also. Friends, the country is moving forward, India. We are all here in the heart of Hyderabad, a prestigious city, a happening city, a historic city. And we are here in another city, Ramoji Film City. A wonder of, a new wonder of the world. We should take advantage of this and create more and more films, meaningful films, constructive films. The country is moving under the leadership of Sri Narendra Modi. The world is recognizing India, it is respecting India everywhere. Earlier, India was used to be downgraded. Now India is being recognized and respected. World economy is going down, slowing down. China is going negative. The only bright spot as of today, the destination for investment is India. I am very happy with that. This is not what Venkaiah Naidu minister saying. This is what the World Bank report says. This is what the ADB, Asian Development Bank report says. This is what World Economic Forum says. This is what Moody rating also says. India is a better destination for investment. So I appeal to all the producers, different film personalities who have come from different parts of the country, please come here, invest, produce, entertain, and earn, and then return. No problem for that. Because this is a land of a great culture, great spiritualism, great heritage. So it invites all, it accommodates all, it assimilates all also. That's a great opportunity. I appeal you all to join Mission Modi. Modi means not our Prime Minister Modi. Modi means making of developed India. Thank you very much.
What an awe-inspiring address by a very awe-inspiring individual, and thank you for sharing, also sharing with us the fun side of you which we got to see today. In the same line of thought, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to request Shri Sohan Roy to facilitate our chief guest, Shri Venkaiah Naidu, by presenting him a memento, a small token of our gratitude. We have the entire